Final artist this evening. Robbie Shaw is a little bit north of the city. I think it's a little bit of a drier area as well, around Ridge Crest, north of Los Angeles. And look, in your bio, it says something about an impending move a little further north to the Bishop area, which on my map, certainly looks a little greener. Tell us a little bit about that as we welcome Robbie Shaw to Red's Room tonight.
So Ridgecrest is very, very brown and hot. It's been like some of the days of this summer has been like 118, 120. It's
Wow.
been pretty intense. And I'm about to drop dramatically the Bishop area. I'm actually going up to Mammoth Lakes, and so I'm probably gonna, in extremes, drop 100 degrees and get a lot more white and green around. So yeah, that's actually happening at the beginning of September. So I got one more month here in Ridgecrest.
Wow. Well, we'll need to pray for you later and for the move and that everything goes well there. But look, we've got to talk about and hear some of your wonderful songs. Tell us a little bit about the first song that you'll be sharing with us.
So this first song is off of my first album. This was just kind of the transition in my life where I started really focusing on the Lord and understanding what He did for me and how to stand in that faith and yeah, the song's just it. There was a time in my life where I felt like I was so alone and I needed that shelter that He gives. And this was the song's called "Here With Me," and it's just singing about Him being with us, even if we don't see it.
No.
that I know. My love, it grows. Your heart broke on that cross, but from the grave
with me. It's Robbie Shaw on Red's Room, concert number 370, across America and around the world this Friday evening. And Hank, your host, thanking you for the opportunity, Mr. Red. And it's just a wonderful evening of listening to inspiring music like that from Robbie Shaw. Comes from your, what did you say, Robbie, your first album?
Yeah, so God, you know, when I first started writing music, is honestly just about 3 years ago. I've played music all my life, but I did secular music and performances, mainly the campfire guy, you know. But when I started shifting my music to worship and glorifying Him, He just started downloading these songs, and over 30 songs in the past 3 years just flooded through me. And so I've structured two albums. The first album that was off of it, it's called Symphony, which I performed that song last time I was on Red's Room. But yeah, that's the first album is Symphony. We're still in the middle of releasing that. We have a 4-song EP on all platforms right now. And then I'm in the middle of recording the second album.
Cool. Well, we'll get you to share how we can connect with you and where we can find all of your music a little bit later. But tell us a little bit more about the second song that you have for us this evening.
So this is also off of the first album. This song is called Turn to You. And again, like I said with the first song, I was just, you know, I was discovering who I was in Christ. And I went through a really hard situation, as I'm sure we all have, that brought us to the Lord. I was going through a divorce and I lost my family, and I lost everything. I felt like Job. I really did. I lost everything I'd known for the past 11 years of my life. It was just gone in an instant. And I was in a discipleship. And that's when a lot of these songs were flowing out of me. And this song, Turn to You, is just me. One of the lines in it actually says, I bleed out this pen, because I was literally just, my heart was pouring out onto the paper of how I felt, what I was going through. And the answer to that was turning to Him, was just, I had to turn to Jesus. And so that's the point of this song.
Thank you. forget things that I regret? When can I breathe again? It's pain in my chest. Oh, I need your rest. I'll reach out for your hand. Please come rescue me. I'll open my eyes to see you. Oh, oh, no. Jesus, I turn to you. Oh, oh, no. Jesus, I turn to you. Just can't let it be. Deep in my soul, I can't let go, and I need you here with me. God, fill this place, this empty space. Lord, change this part of me. I bleed out this pen, don't want this again. Reveal my destiny. Come and rescue me. Open my eyes to see you. Oh no, no. Jesus, I turn to you. Oh no, Jesus, I turn to you. Oh.
To you, Rob Shaw on Red's Room Entertainment 370. Wow, I love this. It's absolutely amazing to hear such great music, inspirational music, glorifying music, pointing people to Christ. And Rob certainly does that this evening. Rob, you have a little bit of a treat teaser for us. For your next song, tell us a little bit about this song.
So the first album has been, it's just been a blessing. It's been a very southern tinge, you know, contemporary rock style. You know, I have a lot of my mentor is Mac Powell from Third Day. That's, so a lot of my inspiration and influence comes from that type of music. And so the first album was a lot like that, but the second album has a little more of a harder sound to it. It's got a little more grungier rock or a deeper heart-filled message. And the name of the second album is Into the Light. And so this song is actually the title song for the newest album called Into the Light. And yeah, so I haven't played this live for anybody yet, so this is a first. But we're in the middle of recording this stuff right now.
Into the Light is the title of the album, and I guess that is the title track. A beautiful song, and I cannot wait to hear that album, Rob. It's going to be absolutely fantastic, if that is any indication of what God is pouring into this project through you. Thank you for sharing that taste of the new album, and yeah, looking forward to it already. Tell us a little about the final song that you have for us.
So I just, you know, I wanted to play some of my music just to get it out there. You know, I'm brand new, you know. I've got two albums, but they're still in the works, and I haven't, you know, started touring or anything like that yet. But I do a traveling worship ministry, and so what I've done for the past 2.5 years is churches that don't have live worship or have worship leaders that, you know, need a day off or just don't have the demand that they need for worship. It breaks my heart to see, because live, tangible worship is important. It's kind of the lubrication to get into a place with God before a message, after a message, or even just to soak in His presence. And so I want to bring that to churches all over the world eventually, but I've been all over Southern California. You know, God's been growing this ministry more and more. At first, it was just a few churches in my town, and now it's been up to 200, 300 miles in every direction. And yeah, I go out, and you know, I'll get calls. I'll go out and I will lead worship at these churches, and I'll just yeah, be available in service. So in that aspect, I just wanted to pour out some worship. This last song isn't one of my songs. It's a song you guys will probably recognize. But I just wanted to, you know, end the night with just a worshipful heart.
must become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Your
sometimes it's just wonderful to relax and bask in the presence of the Lord. And Rob Shaw does that very well in his music. Thank you so, so much, Rob. What was that song called?
That one's called Holy Spirit. It's I don't know if the original artist is Katie Torwalt, but that's somebody that sang it.
Thank you for doing it so well and sharing it with us this evening, along with the little sneak peek into your second album as well, and a couple of tracks from your first album. It's been an absolute inspiration. We pray for you and your ministry and your move. Let's do that now, may we?
Yeah.
Let's lift our hands to our Heavenly Father and pray for Rob. Lord, you have blessed this man incredibly. He has gone through some tumultuous times in his life, but you have always been faithful to him and faithful to your promises for him and your blessings of him. You have inspired him with your word and given him words to share through his music. And we thank you for your inspiration in him and for blessing him with these works that will make up finally two albums and many more, we pray. Bless him in his move from Ridgecrest up to the Bishop area. And we pray for smooth travels, for smooth transition, and for a blessed settling in his new area, and a wonderful people to surround him in that time, leaving Ridgecrest and in the move, and then welcoming him to a new home. Thank you, Lord, for this evening. Thank you for all of our artists, for Rob, for Brittany, and for Thena, and for our wonderful message from Colossians from Rob Reed. We bless you and praise you and ask for your inspiration to continue over Rob and your provision for him and all that he needs to continue to do your work faithfully in the Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And thank you to Rob Shaw in what will be his resting place for tonight at least, and over the next few weeks. When's the move happening, Rob? I think you did mention something about it.
The first week of September.
What a great month.